obviously, we were on three different segments of Fox last week, and out of nowhere, they invited us to come back on again for the Fox Business segment today. Mm-hmm. And in the last 30 minutes, we've had two more invitations for two additional Fox segments. So, obviously, you know, they're intrigued by what we're doing down here, as anyone should be in such dire economic times that we're faced with throughout the country, not just the state of Alabama, particularly in the state of Alabama, in that we're the third fastest growing unemployment state in the United States of America. And, you know, with all the propaganda and innuendo going around with respect to bingo, could get a lot worse. So I think they're intrigued by this. We never fathomed that. No, we didn't anticipate that. We're grateful that they have embraced our project. And they're intrigued by what we're doing down here, and you know, we're just going to keep striving and moving forward.
Right.
We'll improvise and adapt to the issues that keep coming before us.
One word and one word only: bingo.
You know, it's unfortunate that the focus of this project has been bingo, when, as you can see for yourself, it's a very, very minute component of the broad spectrum of the project. With the fact this is a country music entertainment world-class tourist destination point. And when it's finished, when phase one, two, and three are all complete, it'll be like nothing else in the world. You know, look at the Petticoat Junction, the old train depot amphitheater that we're finishing now. Go down and look at Bluegrass Holler RV Park, Possum Holler Bed and Breakfast, mm-hmm. and the different venues that are here. There's so much more here than bingo. Unfortunately, our governor is obsessed with bingo. What kind of an impact has it already had? You know, we've got over 1,100 people out here working today. December 1, we will have in excess of 1,200 people working. And that number is just going to continue to rise over the next 7 years, in that when we open the doors on our bingo pavilion, you have to understand the bingo aspect of this is an absolute necessity. But when we open the doors on our bingo pavilion, we're guaranteed, the Houston County Commission, that we start a new vertical structure here every quarter thereafter. So what does that do? All these construction workers you see out here working, they're going to remain working. It's just going to grow and grow and grow. And our sustained jobs will be somewhere around 6,000 people. That's direct job impact that this project will have on Houston County. But the impact that it's already had, has been phenomenal, considering that we've got in excess of 1,100 people working today.
I voted for Governor Riley twice.
I'm not butting heads with Governor Riley. I am just exercising my constitutional right as an Alabama citizen to bring a great project to fruition. The governor is the one who is indulged in a head-butting ceremony. Unfortunately, in my opinion, he has maliciously abused his office for the last year and a half for his personal agenda. And his personal agenda is to eliminate bingo in the state of Alabama. He's been very, very disingenuous with the citizens of Alabama when he says that bingo is illegal here, electronic bingo is illegal here. Let me tell you, electronic bingo is recognized as a legal format of bingo by the federal court system, and it was recognized in 1988 by IGRA. Electronic bingo has been played in Alabama since the year 1989 by the Native Americans. Mm-hmm. Non-Native American entities have been playing electronic bingo in Alabama since 1992. So 17 years later, why is our governor coming out saying electronic bingo is illegal? Yeah. Well, you know what the rumor mill is that he was funded, his campaign was partially funded by the Choctaw Indians in Philadelphia, Mississippi. One of his cabinet members came out last week and took a polygraph exam that was 100% conclusive, in that he had no reaction to any question that he was asked. And mainstream media has ignored that. So it appears that perhaps there is an agenda there. But one thing that you need to understand, and the rest of the people in Alabama need to understand, Tim, mm-hmm. is the governor has not only been disingenuous with the media, with the citizens of Alabama, but now our legislators. Here's a white paper letter with the governor's signature on it that basically declares that if he eliminates electronic bingo at Victory Land or Country Crossing, then he eliminates electronic bingo for the Native Americans in Alabama as well. That couldn't be further from the truth. He is quoting memos in here as if it were law. Philip Hogan, who was the former chair of NITC, wrote memos and tried to pass into IGRA, Indian Gaming Regulatory Act. He tried to get it accepted, a further definition of electronic bingo by the federal court system for IGRA. Every memo that he took as a resolution to be adopted into IGRA was turned down. Our governor has put it in his letter to our legislators as if it were law. He's telling our legislators, he's telling you, and he's telling me, well, if I close him down, then I close the Indians down. That's not going to happen. Right. He has no jurisdiction whatsoever over the Native Americans. The only way, and it's debatable at that point, that he could close down the Native Americans would be if he repealed every single bingo act in the state of Alabama, which would include paper church bingo, then perhaps he could close down the Native Americans. Well, you and I both know that's not going to happen. But even at that point, the Native Americans will debate and say, no, that's not going to happen either, because we made our investment in the state of Alabama based on existing law. Mm-hmm. The Native Americans are here to stay. And guess what, Tim? That's a non-taxable entity. What we say, it's already here. It's legal. If the governor, he says there are 16,000 untaxed, unregulated bingo machines in Alabama today. Let's just say, hypothetically, he prevails in his quest and he eliminates every electronic bingo facility in the state. There's going to be 16,000 bingo machines here after that. Because what is going to happen is the three Native American facilities in Wetumpka, Tallapoosa, and Atmore are just going to expand their operations to accommodate the additional business that they're going to pick up from the legal, legitimate operations that are in Alabama, and the citizens of Alabama will not receive one dime from those operations because they're non-taxable entities. What we say, and what we've been saying all along, is tax, regulate, and limit bingo within the state. Why wouldn't you want to? It's an untaxed industry. While we're still sitting here today, you know, the governor's talking about pay furloughs for state employees. You're telling me that you're going to send state employees home who deserve to make a living and provide for their families. You're going to send them home when you have another option? You're talking about laying off more school teachers when you have another option? But because of your obsession, or whatever the case may be with bingo, is you're saying it's okay. You know, we have to have budget cuts. We've got to lay teachers off. We can't pay our teachers what a teacher in Georgia makes. A school teacher in Georgia, on average, makes $15,000 a year more than a school teacher in Alabama. You know, every border state that we have has some form of legalized gambling. You have the lottery in Florida that's generated in excess of $20 billion in revenue since its inception. The Georgia lottery system is the strongest merit-based scholarship program in the world. The state of Georgia, by way of their lottery, have sent over 1 million kids to college that deserve to go to college, but otherwise would never have been able to afford to go to college. But because of their lottery in Georgia, they're not going to college. The month of September alone, Mississippi paid $20 million in tax revenues. But you want me to tell you what it boils down to, my friends? Here's the facts as it pertains to gaming in Alabama. And this is fact. This is not propaganda. This is not innuendo. Every single day in the state of Alabama, we have 9,000 Alabamians cross our state line into the state of Mississippi, collectively spending $35,000 per hour, 24 hours a day, 365 days a year. Now, if you want to know what the motivation is behind anyone who's opposed, unless it's for genuine moral reasons, which is, you can't legislate morals anyway, anyone who is opposed to that, there's the underlying motives. Mm-hmm.